Welcome friends, welcome to another tutorial from Brilliant Bias. In this lecture I will talk about T-cell development. This is very important topic, so you must watch this video very carefully. In the beginning I want to mention three important points. The first is self MHC restriction. The second point is self tolerance. And the third is lineage commitment. During the development of T cell in the thymus, these three terms and conditions all the T cells must agree. So these three, like self MHC restriction, self tolerance and lineage commitment, are three terms and conditions all the T cells must agree with this before they come out from the thymus. Self MHC restriction means each and every T cell must recognize its own MHC molecules. Must recognize. Self means own MHC, its own body MHC molecule. It must recognize and restricted. Okay. Now, self tolerance means each and every T cell must tolerate its own protein. Cell protein must tolerate. And lineage commitment means each and every T cell must go to a particular lineage, like T helper and TC cells, cytotoxic T cells. Helper cell or cytotoxic T cell, it has to be choose one lineage. So these three are the term and conditions that the all T cells must follow. Now, the name T cell come from thymus, T for thymus, but you don't confuse that T cell generate from the thymus. No, all immune cells are generated from the bone marrow. So T cell precursor also generate from the bone marrow. Let me draw a bone and then bone marrow. Let's assume this is a bone and here some bone marrow is present. What happens? From this bone marrow, one type of cell come out that called common lymphoid precursor cell. Common lymphoid precursor. This cell is not committed yet. It can generate NK cell, it can generate B cell, it can generate dendritic cell, even myeloid cells like macrophage and T cell. So these cells that actually come out from the bone marrow is not yet committed. Now, let me draw a thymus cross-sectional view. Let's assume this is a thymus. This thymus actually consists of two main regions. One is called cortex region and another is the medulla region. Okay, and in between this cortex and medulla, a region is present that called cortico-medullary junction, CMJ, cortico-medullary junction. Now what happens? This common lymphoid precursor cell actually enter into the thymus through this cortico-medullary junction. They enter through this corticomedullary junction, not from the cortex, not from the medulla, because in the corticomedullary junction blood vessels are present. So these cells actually enter through the blood vessels into the thymus, which is thymus. Okay, now when these cells enter into the thymus, it is called double negative. So what is called it? Double negative. Double negative means these cells do not have two coreceptor. That means it do not have CD4 and CD8 coreceptor. Okay, this is called double negative. And the cell that enters into the thymus, it is called double negative 1, because the double negative cell can be divided into four stages: DN1, DN2, DN3 and DN4. the DN1 cells that enter into the thymus yet not fully committed. But when this cell enter into the thymus epithelial cells have Notch ligand. And that actually starts a signaling process called Notch signaling in the DN1 cell. So that the cell now starts to commutate towards the T cell. So Notch signaling is very important for double negative cell. Notch signaling. Because by this Notch signaling, this cell starts to commutate towards the T cell lineage. Now the DN cell, DN1 cell actually become DN2 cell. And subsequently the DN2 cell become DN3 and the DN3 become DN4. But there are some major changes occur during these transitions. Like in the late DN2 stage, the cell fully committed towards the T cell lineage. I'm repeating again, in the late DN2 stage, the cell become fully committed towards the T cell lineage. And not only that, during the transition from DN2 to DN3, the cell starts to produce gamma, delta and beta gen. You have to remember this. During the transition from the DN2 to DN3, they start to produce T cell receptor chain. What happens? A T cell can be broadly divided into two subsets. One is called gamma delta and another is called alpha beta. In adult human body, the alpha beta T cells are present 99.5% and the gamma delta present 0.5%. Very rare cell population. It actually helps in mucosal immunity. This gamma delta cell helps in mucosal immunity. This gamma delta chain is actually chain of the T cell receptor, and this alpha beta chain is also chain of the T cell receptor. If you assume that this is the T cell, then this is the alpha and this is the beta chain. Looks like this. So these are the chain. When the DN2 starts to become DN3, it expresses this gamma delta B cell, not the alpha chain. So in this situation, VDJ recombination start. VDJ recombinations also start. In my previous class, I have already mentioned that T cell receptor also go through VDJ recombination to make diverse set of T cell receptor. What does it mean, diverse set of T cell receptor? Let's assume if I have 10 million T cell, then I also have 10 million T cell receptor. That means each and every T cell express a unique T cell receptor. So if I have 10 million T cells, then I have 10 million unique T cell receptor that can recognize 10 million different antigen. You have to understand this. So VDJ recombination occurs in this case, but no alpha chain is yet produced. So what happens in the DN3 stage, this DN3 cell starts to produce a pre-T alpha chain, not true alpha chain, it is a surrogate chain, helps the beta chain to form pre-T cell receptor. This is also not true T cell receptor. I'm telling you again, in the DN3 stage, the cell starts to produce a molecule called pre-T alpha. This is not the real alpha chain. It is actually surrogate chain of the alpha. Now, when the pre-T alpha and the beta chain that is already produced associate with each other, it is called pre-T cell receptor. And this pre-T cell receptor is very important. Those DN3 cells cannot produce pre-T cell receptor, cannot survive. Okay. So this production of pre-T cell receptor is very important. Now, the DN3 becomes DN4 and the DN4 become double positive. So another transition, double negative to double positive. Double positive means now this cell is producing CD4 and the CD8 together. This co-receptor, they start to express togetherly. You have to understand this. This is called double positive cell. Okay, now what happened? This double positive cell is present in the cortex. Okay, so this double positive cell actually starts production of alpha chain. So now the alpha chain is produced and it associated with the beta chain. So it produces actually true T cell receptor. you have to understand this. In the double positive cell, true T cell receptor come, because in the double positive cell, alpha chain starts to produce, and this alpha chain and true beta chain combine to each other and form the true T cell receptor, not the pre T cell receptor, true T cell receptor. So this double positive cell have both this coreceptor and true T cell receptor. What happens? In the cortex, there is actually epithelial cells called corticular thymic epithelial cell. Corticular thymic epithelial cell, CTEC. These cells represent self-antigen. Okay? These cells represent self-antigen with the help of class 1 and class 2 MHC molecule. So this CTEC cell can express class 1 and class 2 MHC molecule with self antigen. Now the double positive cell actually give a examinations. Okay, this three term and conditions it has to be maintained. Now it gives examinations. The first result or the first consequences can be during the production of this T cell receptor by VGG recombinations. Many T cell receptors are produced that do not recognize the self MHC molecule. So what happens? The first consequence it may be, if the T cell receptor that is produced during the VGG recombination do not recognize self MHC plus self antigen, then it is not following the first term and conditions. I have already mentioned it in my previous section that all the T cells that come out from the thymus must maintain this first term and condition, that is self MHC restricted. All the T cell must recognize its own MHC molecule. So if any T cell receptor do not recognize self MHC molecule, its own MHC molecule, it will not survive. So it will die. They die by apoptosis, and this type of death is called death by neglect. As the cells neglecting its own MHC molecule, it will not survive. And there is reason why the T cell receptor that do not recognize the self MHC molecule do not survive. The reason behind is T cell receptor cannot recognize peptide or antigen without the help of MHC molecule. If this T cell receptor cannot recognize MHC molecule, it cannot recognize the peptide also or antigen also. So the T cell receptor do not recognize self MHC and self antigen complex, they die. That's called death by neglect. And it has been seen that approximately 90 to 96% of double positive cells die due to this reason. One information I want to share with you, in a mice it has been seen that per day 50 million double positive cells are produced in the thymus, and 90 to 96% of cells die due to this reason, because they produce such type of T cell receptor that cannot recognize the self MHC molecule. So that T cell receptor is actually useless. The second consequence is that if the T cell receptor now recognize self MHC plus self antigen with high affinity, you have to understand this. The first consequence is that self MHC restrictions. These cells are not self MHC restricted. They do not recognize the self MHC, so they die. The second consequence is now the T cell receptor can recognize the self MHC, but the self MHC self antigen complex with high affinity. These CTEC cells, corticular thymic epithelial cells, actually representing class 1 and class 2 MHC molecule and the self antigen. Those double positive cells recognize this self MHC and self antigen complex with high affinity. They also do not survive, they also die. And this is called negative selection. and these cells actually not maintaining the second Taumann conditions. They are violating these three Taumann conditions. The first, these cells actually neglecting this Taumann condition because self tolerance. Each and every T cell must tolerate its self antigen. This T cell receptor is recognizing the self MHC and self antigen with high affinity. It means if this T cell come out from the thymus, it can recognize the self antigen with high affinity and it will harm, because self antigen present in our body cell, so it can harm the body cell and produce autoimmunity. So these cells are called autoreactive T cell or double positive cell. And it has been seen that approximately 2 to 5% of cell die due to this region. 2 to 5% cells die due to this region. And by this way, the thymus actually controlling one important thing called central tolerance. What is called central tolerance? Tolerance means to tolerate the self antigen. Why it is called central? Because when T cell and B cell develop in the bone marrow and thymus, this is called primary lymphoid organ, where the T cell and B cell actually develop. So in this case, if the B cell and T cell develop in the bone marrow and thymus respectively, when they produce B cell receptor, T cell receptor that can recognize self antigen with high affinity, they die. This is called central tolerance, because this tolerance is actually happening. This type of examination is happening in the primary lymphoid organ. So it is called central. There is another type of tolerance occur that called peripheral tolerance. When this T cell or B cells come out into the periphery and then they again give examinations so that they do not recognize the self antigen with high affinity, they also go through a peripheral tolerance. So this is central tolerance. These cells, those who recognize T cell receptor with high affinity, they do not follow the second term and condition, that is self tolerance. Okay, the third situation can occur. The third situation is if the T cell receptor recognize self MHC or self MHC plus self antigen with low or intermediate affinity. You have to understand this. There are the three consequences can occur in the double positive cell when it is present in the cortex. The third situation is the T cell receptor can recognize self MHC or self MHC self antigen. I have written it two times. I will explain why I have written this only self MHC and self MHC self antigen, because this all data or information come from some experiments performed by scientists. I will explain those experiments in my next class. Please watch this video, those who are preparing for CSIR, UGC NET or higher educations. This is the theory, but I will tell you how this information come into existence, because scientists have performed some experiments and they have found that those T cell receptor that can recognize only the self MHC molecule, not with any self antigen complex, if it recognize self MHC molecule just enough, it is just enough for their survival. Or if it recognize, the T cell receptor recognize self MHC and self antigen with low, not very low, low or intermediate affinity, then it will survive. That means it is positively selected, positive selections, because these cells actually maintaining these two rule, self MHC restrictions. This T cell receptor recognize self MHC or self MHC and self antigen with low or intermediate affinity. That means it is tolerating its own self antigen. So these cells actually maintaining this first and second rule, so it is actually survive. This is positive selections. Approximately 2 to 5% of double positive cells survive. So this is only the percentage that actually survive during the training procedure of this double positive cell in the cortex. So three things can occur. You have to remember this. So let's assume now this double positive cell, when selected negatively and die, only the surviving cells actually came into the medulla region. And in the medulla, there is another cell called MTEC. What does it mean, MTEC? MTEC means medullary thymic epithelial cell. And there is some dendritic cell also present in the medulla of the thymus. So in the cortex, two things occur. The first thing is negative selection and positive selections. Okay? And some cell died because they do not recognize the self MSC. The majority of the cell died. Now, when this double positive cell go through these examinations, they become single positive cell. They, when enter into the medulla, they become single positive. They are not now double positive. They are single positive. So SP. SP means single positive. Single positive means now the cell can have only one coreceptor, have CD4 or CD8. Do not have both the coreceptor. Now those cells have the CD4, they are called T helper cell, and those are have the CD8 called cytotoxic T cell. You have to remember this. Now the cell becomes single positive. Now they are actually maintaining the third term and condition. They have chosen a lineage. The lineage is T helper and T cytotoxic T cells. Okay. Now another round of examination are performed by these single positive cells. They go through another examinations. That is, this MTEC cell is somehow very special. I want to mention here, this MTEC cell is somehow special than the CTEC cell, because this MTEC cell express a molecule that called AIRE. That means autoimmune regulator. You have to remember this. This MTEC cell is somehow advanced or modern than the CTEC cell, because this MTEC cell expresses a molecule called AIRE. What is the significance of this molecule? This AIRE molecule can produce by transcription tissue specific antigen. You have to remember this. Tissue-specific antigen. At first, the CTEC cell is expressing self-antigen, that is ubiquitous. Ubiquitous means, like in our all cells, actin molecule are present. This type of molecule are called ubiquitous, that is present in all our body cell. But tissue have very unique some proteins, like our liver cells, hepatocyte, have some unique proteins. Our pancreatic cells have unique protein, like pancreatic cells can only produce insulin and glucagon. No other body cell can produce this. So each and every tissue has its specific antigen. This CTEC cell cannot produce this tissue specific antigen. Like this cell cannot produce liver protein, pancreatic protein, kidney protein or stomach enzyme. They cannot produce. But this MTEC cell, with the help of AIRE, can produce this tissue specific antigen into the thymus. That is very rare. That is very interesting fact. Now this MTEC cell is producing liver antigen, pancreatic antigen or stomach antigen, kidney antigen, that is specifically expressed only those tissue. But a condition must be actually fulfilled by this single positive cell, that they do not recognize this cell tissue specific antigen also. They must not recognize the self antigen, that is first condition, and also the single positive cell do not recognize the tissue specific antigen also. Because if this single positive cell can recognize tissue specific antigen, they will harm the organ. If this single positive cell can recognize tissue specific antigen of hepatocyte, it will attack the liver and kill the liver cell. So this MTEC cell actually take another examination of the single positive cell to check whether these single positive cells are recognizing this tissue specific antigen with high affinity or not. If the single positive cell recognize this tissue specific antigen with high affinity, they are negatively selected. You have to understand this. So this is very important thing I want to mention here, that is CLP. So tissue specific antigen means in our body some tissues are very specifically actually produce some proteins that is not present in other tissue, like insulin, glucagon. These are only present in the pancreas, not other cells. But this MTEC cell, with the help of AIRE, can produce all these tissue antigen. So to check whether this single positive cell are actually cell reactive towards this antigen or not. So in the medulla, what happened? Only negative selection occur of these single positive cells. So they go through negative selection process. So you have to remember this. The first thing is, in the cortex, both negative selection and positive selection occurs. But in the medulla, no positive selection occurs because the cells are positively selected already. Now they have to check that the cells that coming from the cortex, the single positive cells, are not tissue specific antigen, recognizing this tissue specific antigen with high affinity. Those cells recognize this tissue specific antigen with high affinity, they are negatively selected. Okay, like this. If any T cell recognize the cell MHC and tissue specific antigen with high affinity, they die, negatively selected. Only single positive cell, that is TC cells, or single positive cells like T helper cells, that means CD8 positive cell and CD4 positive cells, come out. Those who are not cell reactive, these cells actually maintaining these three term and condition. First is self MHC restrictions. They can recognize its body own self MHC molecule for these positive selections. Now they will not actually harm our body because they are self tolerant, because these negative selections, the first negative selection and the second negative selection, by this way the cells now self tolerant. It can tolerate its own body antigen or tissue specific antigen. Another is lineage commitment. They have committed toward the CD8 and CD4 cells. At first there was common lymphoid precursor, and I have mentioned that in this situation this cell can become NK cell, dendritic cell, B cell, even myeloid cell, macrophage like cell, and T cell. So from this uncommitted cell, now the cell when go through this thymus development, producing CD8 and CD4 cells that are lineage committed. Okay, so this is all about thymus or T cell development, thymus dependent T cell development. In my next class, I will explain 4 experiments by which all these informations have come into existence. Scientists have known this fact. You must know that experiment, those who are preparing for CSIR, UGC NET or higher educations. So must watch this my next video. Thank you for watching, and always keep learning.